Today I want to demonstrate how to use a vernier calipers to measure the depth of a beaker, but instead of using a beaker, I'll be using a cup for my illustrations. This is Kisembo Academy and thanks for tuning in. Before I dive into that, we know that besides using this vernier calipers to measure the depth of this cup, we can still use this vernier calipers to find the internal diameter of this, and if we are to find it, use the internal diameter of this, we simply are going to use these external jaws and we are going to slide it like that. Make sure that the inside jaws grip the cup like that and we are able to take our readings right there. Then if you want to find the external diameter of this, we are simply going to use these external jaws and we are going to put them in right there. We make sure that we slide this vernier scale. We ensure that the sliding jaw gets in grip with this in a certain way, and then we are able to take our readings right there. Now the purpose of this video is to show you how we find the depth of this cup using this vernier calipers. Now if you look at this vernier caliper, whenever I slide this, something outside here protrudes. When this thing is at the zero mark, let's look at it here. If you were to look at it closely right there, when the jaws are fully closed, the thing is at zero. As you can see right there, the main scale is at zero, and even the first graduation of the vernier scale is coinciding with the zero mark on the main scale. That is when the jaws are fully closed. And when it's at that point when the jaws are fully closed, you notice that at the back of my vernier caliper, we are having a certain strip right here. This strip is tied to this sliding jaw. This one here. So when I slide this jaw, this strip at the back, this one, it protrudes out. So when the jaws are fully closed, this strip is also, it's just at the edge of the. So when I start sliding this right there, like that, this strip starts protruding out like that. So the more I slide this, the longer this thing protrudes out. So now what do we do? When our vernier calipers is fully closed, I'm going to get this vernier. This is my cup. I want to measure the depth of this. So I'll start sliding so that this thing comes out. This. So when it starts coming out, this is what I'm going to use and put right in there. So as I slide my jaw, this thing protrudes out. And then I dip it right there. So I'll just keep regulating this sliding jaw right here. So you realize that when I adjust the sliding jaw, this protrusion, that metal strip, goes up to the bottom of this cup. And so it means that the depth of this cup is just this distance. So it means that this distance, which is the depth of this cup, is going to coincide with the distance this sliding jaw has moved from here to that point. So it means that after measuring my depth like that, I'll simply come here to my vernier caliper and I'll take the readings. It is as simple as that. So for those of you who do not know how to take the readings, then I'll continue and show you how we take readings on the vernier caliper. So when you are talking about readings on the vernier caliper, we are going to record two readings. There is the reading we call the main scale reading. This is the main scale reading. Then we have the vernier scale. Now the vernier scale is this thing that is sliding. That's the vernier. It has got small graduations on top. Some graduations on the vernier scale. And it is from this vernier. And it is from these graduations of the vernier scale that we are able to take the reading of the vernier scale. So how exactly do we take this reading? This is how we do it. We shall first take the main scale reading. And now if you look at our main scale, we have 10, then 11. Of course, this is 10, 10.1, 10.2, 10.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 10.9, then 11. So what we do is that we are going to read our main scale from this figure 10 up to the point where the vernier scale begins from. The vernier scale begins from this point. So it means that we are going to read our main scale up to the point where it stops. So our main scale is going to be 10, 10.1, 10.2. So it means that we stop there. just before we start where the main the vernier scale starts from. So our main scale is 10.2. So our main scale reading here is 10.2. And of course it is in centimeters. Now then we start reading our vernier scale. Now our vernier scale has got graduations that are not numbered. But we are supposed to be counting these sticks. If I may label them, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we are going to count these graduations right from 0. And then the one we stop on, we are going to stop on the one that first coincides with a line in the main scale. So if you look at it, these ones here, if you look at this first graduation 0, it does not coincide with anything in the main scale. Look at the 1, it does not coincide with anything. 2 doesn't. 3 doesn't. 4 doesn't. Then we have the fifth line. The fifth line is the first line to coincide with a line in the main scale. So when we reach on that fifth line, we stop there. So it means that our vernier scale is running from 0 up to 5. So when we reach the fifth line, then we are going to write our main scale, but we are going to multiply it by 0.01. Why? Because our vernier scale is meant to give us the second place of decimal. That is the importance of this vernier scale. So much as we have counted from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to the fifth, it means that we are going to get this as 5 times 0.01, and of course our answer there is 0.05. So it means our vernier scale here is 0.05, and then when we add, it means that our overall answer is 10.25. That's in centimeters. So it means that our vernier scale reading is 10.25 centimeters. Let's do some one more example. We're going to do the same thing as before. We are going to count our main scale first, and we are going to stop at the point where the vernier scale begins from. So the vernier scale reading begins from here. So it's going to be 7, 7.1, 7.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 7.6. So we stop here. So it's going to be 7.6. Of course, that's in centimeters. Then we get to our vernier scale. Our vernier scale has got those graduations, so let's label them. We have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we begin. 1 does not coincide with anything. The 0, then we have the 1, does not coincide. 2, nothing. 3, then we have the 4th. Then we have the 5th again. The 5th line coincides with the first line, coincides with the line in the main scale. They're in the same straight line. So it means again, just like before, it's going to become 5 times 0.01. We multiply it by 0.01 because the vernier scale gives us the accuracy to the second place of decimal. So our answer here is going to become 0.05. And when we add, we get 7.65 centimeters. And that is how we take readings on a vernier scale, and that is how we use this vernier scale to find the depth of a cup or a beaker or a vessel. This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Feel free to check out other excellent videos on the channel, and don't forget to subscribe. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Rangakuramia helping you manifest excellence.